In this video, I'll walk you through the nitty-gritty of cutting on flat surfaces by modeling a knife. We'll cover how to break down complex geometry, switch between smooth and sharp corners, make cuts in two ways, and control mesh density. Without further ado, let's dive right in. Drag and drop the reference image. I'll leave the link in the description below. Take a cube as a size reference and scale the image to match the real-life size. I'll install these two built-in add-ons. Before we start modeling, let's take a look at the topology. The hilt looks complex, but we can simplify it by breaking it down into quads and pentagons. Now we've got two fives and three fours. Let's break these shapes down further to add more detail. Hold Shift, Control, and Alt to ring select all these edges at once, then subdivide to create the cuts. Press Shift R to quickly repeat the last operation. Now inset the faces to create the cutouts. Move the verts into position. I'll speed it up a bit here. I'll subdivide the ring edges for support loops. Cut and collapse these two lines to merge them into a bigger loop. Another option is using the knife tool for manual cuts if you've planned your edge flow. Turn on auto merge vertices to merge them as you slide. Make a cut here for even density, then press Ctrl 2 to add the sub-D modifier and preview the final result. The corner here needs to be tighter for sharp transitions. Let's check out this chevron shape and see how to switch between sharp and smooth corners. After sub D, the left corner is smoother, while the right one is tighter. Just like that, these are the two types of internal corners. If you're enjoying this video, please give me a like and subscribe. Your support really means a lot. Now that we've got the sharp and smooth corners down, let's dive into fine-tuning the shape. In face mode, merge the two pieces with F. I'll bevel the edges for smoother transitions. Now that we've got the basic shape, let's make room for the rivets. Inset the face and subdivide once to get enough faces for the circle. Use Loop Tool's circle command to create a perfect ring. Press K to invoke the knife tool and cut the edge loops manually. We can't easily make this hole by subdividing, so let's try another approach. Add a circle and reduce the vertex count to 8, that's the minimum for good circle topology. Press Shift D to copy the circle, one for the cut, one for the support loop. Switch to the base mesh, hold Ctrl and select the circle, then go to Mesh and choose Knife Project. Clean up the extra verts by merging them to the nearest ones. I'll move the 5-point poles from the boundaries to the support edge loops in the flat inner areas. Use the same technique to create these two holes. I'll skip this part for now. Go to the Select menu, use the non-manifold tool to pick the boundary edges, set their edge weight to 1. Add a solidify modifier to give the knife some thickness. Right-click and select Apply Rotation and Scale to update the mesh transformation data. Set the bevel method to Weight to bevel only the marked edges. Tweak the other parameters until the hilt looks the way you want. Apply the Solidify modifier, and now the hilt has real thickness. Slide these verts to give the handle a slight bevel. Once that's set, hide the hilt for now and let's jump into modeling the blade. Like before, let's check the blade's topology before we start modeling. I'll split the shape to match the blade's flow and keep an eye on details in the mesh, like this line here. The grind face is slightly uneven. I'll use the flatten tool to smooth it out. The serration pattern is repetitive, so I'll just copy and paste a section to finish it quickly. Combine the two parts by pressing Ctrl J. Thank you. Subdivide this edge 3 times to match the 3 teeth here. The mesh density is a bit high here, so I'll merge and dissolve some unnecessary edges. Press Shift, S, and choose Cursor to Selected from the menu. Back to Object Mode, right-click and choose Set Origin to 3D Cursor. Now we've used the cursor to move the mesh origin to the symmetry axis. Select the blade, then the hilt, press Ctrl L to copy modifiers. The artifacts here can be fixed by switching Miter Outer to Arc. Always place the mirror modifier at the top of the stack. Check the normals to finish up modeling. If you see red, press Shift N to flip them. Feel free to finish the minor parts. I'll skip those in this video. These techniques work for any cuts on flat surfaces, razor blades, guitar picks, and more. That's it for this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more Blender tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.